As Malaysians, we should have a dream for all of us. A dream where this country belongs to all of us, where we can live with respect and with dignity. That is our dream. And that is my dream. And that's why I don't have to say that. After 22 years of authoritarian rule, followed by 5 years of no rule, and now we have another authoritarian leader who is bent on dividing us using race, using religion, using whatever they can at their disposal to divide us. This is a challenge for all of us. We need to restore democracy in this country. We need a representative government to listen and care for the people, for ordinary people of this country. And it is not an easy task. It's not an easy task. Last week I was asked in Bangsa, you know, a middle class crowd, can we, Pakatan, do this job? Are we capable? Do we have the right leaders to achieve this lofty goal? And my answer is an unequivocal yes. Yes, we have. I will explain to them, and I will explain to you the same thing. Do not think that Pakatan Rakyat is a bunch of global parties, political parties with disparate, different ideologies, different approach, different struggles, all interested into being Putrajaya. Pakatan is more substantive than that. If you look at the history of the partners in Pakatan, if you look at the past struggle for justice, for over 45 years, they have suffered. They have suffered in the hands of UMNO, right? From the ordinary members in Kelantan, right up to everywhere else in Malaysia. Their leaders have been imprisoned. Their intellectuals have been detained under ISIS. They have suffered under the system. So they know the score. You look at DAP, they too have struggled. They always talk about rule of law, good governance, anti-corruption. They too have paid sacrifices. Kit Siang himself was detained. Guan Eng was imprisoned. And of course, Dato Sri himself paid a heavy price. All because he wanted to change this country. He spent 7 or 6.5, I don't know exactly, this guy below. We all have suffered, and because of that suffering, because we know the system is so rotten, that will keep us together. Despite all the so-called problems and, you know, some people pointing out some of the difficulties you've been experiencing lately. Despite all of that, I am confident, and I want to urge you to share my confidence. We have what it takes to bring our country. I have no illusion about the difficulty of governing this country after so many years of misrule. I have no illusion. Because we are all multi-racial, multi-ethnic, we come from different backgrounds, different schools. Our schools are all divided into sectors, vernacular, English, Islamic school, normal school, we are divided by language, by so many things. Of course it's difficult to govern this country after all these years on this world. So because we are trying to bring back sanity and bring back reasonableness, we are bringing back the people's voice to be heard. Of course you will have this, of course you will have this perceived problem. And I'm making no excuses. I think we all have to work harder at the leadership level. We have to make commitments and strong statements and principled statements. We cannot, for the sake of political expediency, sacrifice the cardinal principle that we cannot divide the people of this country into compartments. We must be united. We are the truly one Malaysia party. And please, don't believe in Ajit, don't believe in him. They say it's very popular. I say, how popular? Popular, let's have election in Pera. Let's see. He's one Malaysia. He's one Malaysia. Right hand, he has proclaimed something that, well, he's a Chinese. for the normal day. And then on the left hand, he will do something else. Up the ante for the Malays. He's playing his game. Ah, he will ask his deputy to attack Datuk Seri. He blamed Datuk Seri for the ISA rally Saturday of first August. And then when it's not, it doesn't sound credible, he blamed the Chinese. He said, actually, it's the Chinese who made us all march on Saturday. They have gone cuckoo. This is one Malaysia I imagine. So don't be easily impressed with all this, what we call bayar. There are serious issues of policies that we have to overcome. And this is what he should be doing. As a responsible Prime Minister, he shouldn't be pandering to this cheap publicity. He should not. And I hope the people of Negeri Sembilan will carry this message to others who are not here. We have before us a huge task. We have to be united. PAS and DAP must learn to live together. Padilla and the DAP and PAS must learn to live together. We all must learn to compromise, give and take, without abandoning the basic principles which we all share. We want good governance. We want less of corruption. We want the rule of law, so that the law that's applicable to me is applicable to you, applicable to a taxi, applicable to a dollar or Yakub or Alon or Achor. We want law, rule of law. Enough of fixing things. This is what we want. So I am saying this. What choice do we have? Okay, Pakatan may have to sort out certain things. We were. But what choice do we have? I can assure you, Barisan cannot change, UMNO cannot change. I was there 23 years as a loyal UMNO man, trying very hard to make them look good and sound good. I'm suggesting changes since I was an ordinary member in the early 90s. I started politics very late. I was only 40 years old. So I wasn't in a rush to go anywhere. So I was able to focus on some of this issue. And we tried very hard, those who are what we call reformists in the party. But once you have this fixation about race, once you think your race is better or more superior or you spoil it, we must be guided by our religious teaching. We must be guided by universal values. That is the only safest way to run any country in this world. That is the only way. And UMNO cannot change. Cannot change. And if UMNO cannot change, MIC and Gerakyat, they don't count. You look at it. It's true. Najib, but I'm sure Mazhar told something can disappear from Batuket, but I'm coming. Yeah, I didn't see something very good. And if you look at Kosuku, Okila is a minister, PM's department. What can Kosuku do? Well, measure KPI. Well, where is Gerakyat today? I'm sorry if there's some Gerakyat members here. You better join Gerakyat.